How you doing, everybody? Today, we're doing a video all about saxophone solos. I'm gonna show you some of my favorite saxophone solos ever made. I'm gonna show you some of, some cool saxophones that I've played over the years. I've dug through the ancient videos off Facebook. I dug them off Facebook, and I'm gonna be showing them to you. And some videos that, my uncles played. Cool solo that this guy I met named Craig Durst played. It's all gonna be on there. You're gonna be delving into the ultimate saxophone solo video here. So I hope you guys enjoy. But yeah, this first solo, I guess I'm just gonna show it to you. It's in the intro of every video on Rick and Welvis. But I don't. Well, actually, I'll take that back. I have showed you the whole solo, but I don't. The whole solo's not in the video, so here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna show you the entire solo, and then after that I'm gonna show you the entire solo that's actually up online, because the solo that I have in the intro is actually, like, I think I'm the only one that owns that. It's like some older recording, but I like it better for some reason. So yeah, guys, without further ado, here it is. So yeah, guys, there it was. It's interesting. That first one, that's the one I used in the intro, and I've been showing people that one for years. I always thought it was awesome, cause my uncle gave me a CD of that band, Make It Groove. I actually played with them. Maybe I'll show. I don't know. Maybe I'll show back a clip from there when I played a solo with them. And yeah, but yeah, I played with them, and when I was living in Missouri, in the Missouri vlogs, the early ones. So yeah, that was cool, but that's the band. And the second one, Eric's probably gonna be shocked to hear that, because he's never heard that. That's the actual recording that they have online, which is interesting to me. But yeah, man, that was pretty dang cool. On the second one, he was playing as Barry Overt, so it was like two solos at the same time. It was pretty awesome. All right, guys, but anyway, the next solo we're gonna be playing, this is a solo, saxophone solo that I've always thought was, like, for a long time, I thought it was the greatest solo I've ever heard. It's a solo from a song called The Hunch by Stanton Moore in an album called Flying the Coop. So without further ado, I hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
yeah, guys, that was that. That shit, that fucking solo. I've always thought it was the coolest solo. I used to tell people it was the best solo ever made. I don't think I really believe that anymore. It is really fucking awesome. He really sets those keys on fire, dude. It's really good. Actually, interestingly enough, that solo, that Naked Groove No Funk solo that you heard previously, that's also one of my favorite solos of all time. And that's not, I'm not just saying that because it's my uncle who played it. I just think it's a really good solo. But yeah, guys, that was really good. And actually, after in that same song, there's another soloist that comes right after him. And personally, I don't like it as much, but you might like it more, but I'm not going to put it. So if you want to hear it, just go look for the song. I'll put a link, and you can go listen to it for yourself and be the judge. All right, guys, for this next solo, it's going to be from a song that I recently started listening to. It. I love it, man. It's called Memories from Sirocco by Chuck Mangione. And this is an underrated artist here, man. And the solo, soprano saxophone solo in this song is freaking fire, man. He sets those keys ablaze. I'm surprised his fingers are still even on his body. Just kidding. Now, it's not even the fact that he's playing really fast. It's the fact that he's also hitting these crazy altissimos. And I know there's a lot of solos like that, but this one, I just fucking love it. So here it is, Memories from Sirocco. Guys, that was that. That's actually probably one of my, it actually might be my favorite solo right now. I freaking love that saxophone solo. He just that's a damn good player, man. And I, no one really talks about him. I don't think he's very well recognized. Neither is Chuck Mangione. I think he's pretty underrated. People only know him for his one song, Feels So Good, and it's just, yeah, but he's awesome. That song is awesome. Yeah, you should really check it out. Check out the full song. It's a great song. It's really chill. But I love that solo, man. It's amazing. It's the perfect blend of, like, it's very lyrical, but it's also, like, got the awesome speed and, like, the patterns. And then it's just, like, oh, man, the altissimos, and it's just, it's great. Here, I'm going to play another solo, another really great solo by this same saxophone player. Yeah, guys, that solo is super awesome too, man. I love that one too. It was just so fast. That was just straight fire that time. He was ripping, man. And the way he, like, I don't know if you guys heard that one part where he, like, it was like he played between a C, and he switched fingerings for it, like, to the rhythm, to the beat, where he did, like, hit the low fingering for C, except harmonically up. So, like, he did, like, he did the low octave fingering for C, except pressed his octave key or something, so that it played the same, like, the same frequency as the mid-range C. And then while he was doing that, he was switching to the actual mid-range C fingering, and that adds a really cool effect when they go above and beyond and add little things like that. It just makes the solo so much more awesome. All right, guys, for this next solo, I guess I'm going to show something from a song called Tank by Cowboy Beep. No. It was in the movie. It was in the show Cowboy Bebop, but it's by a band called The Seatbelts. Really good solo. I'm only gonna show you the recorded version, but actually there's the better version. There's actually probably a better version, and it's like a live recording online. And I don't think I'm gonna show it to you. I don't know. I might end up changing my mind and showing it to you, but if not, I'll leave a link in the description. You guys should check it out for yourself. So here it is. Yeah, that solo was awesome, and you know, I might end up showing you the next, you know, the part where it was like that, it was like a live recording, but I might not at the same time. But yeah, if it is, then it's in there, but if it's not, then yeah. All right, guys, so that was pretty awesome. So yeah, I think that's a really good solo too. All right, guys, so next we're going to be transitioning into I'm going to be talking about some of my solos that my uncle has played over the years. I'm going to pick out some parts from some that I thought were really awesome. And just kind of show them to you all in a line. And yeah, it'll be awesome because my uncle's a pro sax player, and just wanted to commemorate him a little bit and show some of his solos. And yeah. We'll be right back. So yeah, guys, that was just a few of some awesome solos and recordings that Michael Stuart has done over the years. That last one was from a band called Jeremiah Johnson Band featuring the Sliders, and the first two were from a band called the Sliders. And yeah, guys, just some awesome stuff. And there's some awesome Naked Groove ones too. And I mean, he doesn't really record a lot. He mostly like just performs. I don't know. They just don't have that much time to record and all that, but. Yeah, man, I put a link to Naked Groove on Bandcamp. They only have one album out, but I put a link to it on every video, so you should check him out, man. But yeah, I mean, you guys have heard, I think, a little bit of his awesome playing when we were in, like, rehearsing on some videos with Naked Groove. Maybe I'll put some clips in there from that if you guys don't remember the Missouri vlogs. Yeah, but anyway, guys, so that's Michael Stuart. He's a pretty awesome dude. Listening to him in person, man, it's like, Jesus Christ, he sounds freaking godlike at the saxophone. It's like, his tone is so ridiculously good. Gosh, it's freaking, I don't know, it's awesome, man. The power of his tone is what sets him apart, in my opinion. He's got such a powerful tone, man, like, gosh. Like, I've heard other guys over there, like, there's this one guy named Blind Willie that was playing with him, and he was really good too. He was extremely good too, and he had a pretty good tone, but something about it, it sounded like a piece of metal, if you know what I mean. Like, it didn't sing the same way. I don't know, something about it just, yeah. But anyway, guys, that's awesome.